Blackstone Publishing presents Mr. Emerson's Wife by Amy Belding Brown. This book is read by Gabrielle Cuir. This book is dedicated to the memory of my father, Robert French Belding, 1921 to 1969. He blessed me with the passion of intellect, the magic of story, the felicity of humor, and the benediction of unconditional love. Part 1, January 1835 to April 1839. Lidian. A woman of well-regulated feelings and an active mind may be very happy in single life, far happier than she could be made by a marriage of expediency. Lydia Maria Child. 1. Manners. Grace, beauty, and caprice build this golden portal. Graceful women, chosen men, dazzle every mortal. Ralph Waldo Emerson. Had I known how momentous the evening would be, I would not have tarried at my chamber window that afternoon, but busied myself in preparation. As it was, 3 o'clock found me lifting the curtain to watch a red sleigh drawn by 2 black chargers skim down the hill to the harbor. The morning's clouds had long since streamed out to sea, leaving blue sky and 4 inches of new wet snow blanketing all of Plymouth. The horses cast vaporous balloons to the air and flung up their heads as if intoxicated by the change in weather. Of the storm, only an ashen streak remained on the horizon, lying over the water like a bitter dream. That, and the combers breaking in chalky ribbons against the wharf pilings. I let the curtain fall and turned in time to see Sophia bolt past my door in her chemise, dark hair flying. Sophia! 14, nearly grown, yet still wild as a colt, my niece was as much a trial to my sister Lucy as I'd been to our mother. With her long, sharp nose and gray eyes, she even resembled me. Sophia, what sort of behavior is this? I crossed to the doorway and regarded her with elaborate solemnity, though I had to master a smile to do so. Sophia stopped beneath the portrait of my father, which had hung in the same spot since it was painted 10 years before his death. Her cheeks were a frenzy of red splotches. She dipped her chin and brought her index fingers together at her waist in a posture that she likely hoped I'd perceive as properly demure.
Aunt Lydia?
She smiled up at me through long lashes. Practicing, no doubt. Before long, some young man would be the recipient of that look. I glanced at my father's likeness to derive strength from the stern line of his mouth, his judging gaze. If you expect to attend Mr. Emerson's lecture this afternoon, you must comport yourself as a lady, I said. You are not a wild animal. Sophia bowed her head, yet I caught the pucker of agitation, of mischief even, upon her young brow. I stepped into the hall and said after her, "Ladies do not run down hallways half-dressed. Ladies walk with elegance and grace, even when they're in a hurry."
"Yes, Aunt Lydia."
"Show me." Sophia closed her eyes and took 4 prim steps. "No, no, that's not it at all. Look." I walked the length of the hall. My hem sighed over the carpet. My arms swung quietly against my skirts. I knew how it looked. It was plain in Sophia's admiring glance. I was gliding rather than walking. It appeared as if my slippers never touched the floor. It was an effect I'd spent years perfecting. I turned and walked back to her. "Now you. Lengthen your neck, feel it stretch, and let your body hang from your shoulders. Look, imagine it as a bolt of fabric draped across your bones." "My bones?" My niece made a face. "Your flesh is a kind of fabric, is it not?" I adjusted my sleeves at the wrist and saw that a thread had come loose and the hem must soon be mended. a task I did not relish. It ought to be cared for and worn with grace, I said. Now, you show me you've learned what I taught. Droplets of perspiration had dampened the tiny curls in front of her ears. I touched one, and it wound instantly around my finger. Show me, I said, dropping my hand to her shoulder and turning her so that I could observe her back as she walked obediently to the head of the stairs, where she turned and came back to me. I nodded.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.